For our video tutorial for today, I'm going to show you what is a line, construction line, and multiline. In AutoCAD, if you are making a 2D drawing, most likely you would need to start your drawing using lines. So let's start with the construction line. Construction line or X line is the second icon located at the draw toolbar. Construction line creates a line of infinite length. You can use it as a construction and reference line. To use the construction line, select the construction line icon from the draw toolbar and click anywhere inside the graphic window. You can make a line infinite in both sides. To make a perfect horizontal or vertical line, you just need to press F8 or select ortho mode located at the status bar. Move your mouse to the right and click, then move your mouse downward or upward to make a perfect vertical line, and click. Then press escape. At this point, you're able to make a 4-quadrant, commonly used as a reference or guide for various drawings. Now let's draw a line. A line creates straight line segments. There are two options on how to input a command. One is by clicking the icon from the draw toolbar. And the other one is by typing the command at the command line text window. And press enter to execute the command. If you are using latest version of AutoCAD, 2014, 2016 up to 2019, you may just type L for line command. Let's create a line using the first option. Select the line icon from the draw toolbar. You can see a command from the command line text window that says specify first point. Click anywhere inside the graphic window for your first point. Move your mouse to the right to specify your next point. Then click and press escape to terminate the command. Now you have a line. But it is not a perfect horizontal line. Let's create a perfect horizontal line. Again, click the line icon from the draw toolbar. Click anywhere inside the graphic window to specify first point. Press F8 or select ortho mode from the status bar. Move your mouse to the right to specify your next point, then click and press escape to terminate the command. Now you have a perfect horizontal line. Always remember that after you click or select for your first point, you can move your mouse to any direction for your next point of your line. You can create horizontal, vertical, and inclined lines. I hope that you were able to follow. Now, I'm going to show you how to draw multi-line or M-line. If you can't find the icon for M-line on your draw toolbar, you may type it in your command line text window. Just type M-line and press enter. Type S to change the scale setting. Press enter. Let's have a scale of 2 to have visible M line. Press enter. M line is like a parallel line. Click at the center or anywhere inside your graphic windows for your first point. Press F8 to allow ortho mode on. This will help you make horizontal and vertical parallel lines. Move your mouse to the right and click to specify next point. Then press escape to end the command. You may use M-line to create the inside and outside wall of a house if you are making a floor plan. Let us try to draw a rectangle using line and M-line. For line, select the line icon from the draw toolbar. Click anywhere inside the graphic window to specify first point. Press F8. Move your mouse to the right to specify your next point, then click. Move your mouse down to specify your next point, then click. Make sure it is shorter than the horizontal line. Move your mouse to the left to specify your next point, then click. Just make sure it's not longer than your first horizontal line. Move your mouse up so that it will intersect with your first horizontal line and click. Then press escape. Don't worry with the excess line. You just need to use trim command to remove the excess lines. To trim, just type the command trim using the command line text window, then press enter. Select your drawing, move your mouse to the upper left of your drawing and drag the mouse to select the entire drawing and click. Press enter. Select and click the unwanted lines. If your drawing is too big or too small, just push the scroll wheel back and forth to zoom in and zoom out. Just make sure that your cursor or crosshair is located at the center of your drawing before you push the scroll wheel back and forth to zoom in and zoom out. If you're done, press escape. Now let's create a rectangle using M-line. Type M-line using the command line text window, and press enter. Type S to change the scale setting. Press enter. Let's have a scale of 2 to have visible parallel lines. Press enter. Click to specify first point, press F8 or select ortho mode to on. Move your mouse to the right and click to specify next point, then move your mouse down. Make sure it is shorter than the horizontal line. Click to specify next point. Then move your mouse to the left and click. Just make sure that the length of your line going to the left is not longer than the first horizontal line. Move your mouse up to intersect with the first horizontal line and click. Press escape to terminate the command. Again, don't worry with the excess line. You just need to use trim command to remove the excess lines. But before you can trim, you need to use explode command in order to convert M-line from polyline into a line segment. To do that, type explode using the command line text window and press enter. Select your drawing. Move your mouse to the upper left of your drawing. Click and drag the mouse down to select the entire drawing. And click. Press enter. Now you can select each line segment. To trim, just type the command trim using the command line text window. Select your drawing. Move your mouse to the upper left of your drawing and click and drag the mouse down to select the entire drawing and click. Press enter. Select and click the unwanted lines, and you're done. I hope that you were able to follow all the command that I used in making a construction line, and in making a rectangle using a line and M-line. Important points to remember is that when you are going to make straight line, don't forget to use F8 or ortho mode. Another one is don't worry about excess lines, you just need to use trim command. Thank you very much guys for watching. For more AutoCAD tutorials, feel free to like, subscribe and share my YouTube channel.